distance, there are few cities finer on a clear afternoon than this one, and we have a picture-perfect day for football at Lumen Field in Seattle.
Today we've got a matchup here in pivotal Week 7 between the Arizona Cardinals and the Seattle Seahawks. Getting toward the halfway point of the NFL season, Week 7 is underway on EA Sports.
Coming out of the end zone, D. Eskridge. And the decision to bring it out, not a good one, as he's tackled at the 15.
Now it's Lock. That's complete to DK Metcalf. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds. A well-executed 22-yard gain. And we see the emphasis early here. Get your star receiver involved, able to do it successfully.
Not a bad start to begin with, that's for sure. And to me, this play says, our guy is better than your guy's. Because, you know, a player of his stature, he won't just be single covered all game long. It's going to involve multiple people. And right away, they told the other team, guess what? He's just better.
Going for Metcalf on the deep ball. And incomplete on the deep ball.
The Seahawks sitting at a very solid 4-2 record through the first 6 weeks. And they've been playing their best football of the year, winners of 4 in a row.
And I thought that they played pretty well last week. Their execution, their discipline, their resilience, all on display in that victory.
They'll try again from the 36 on 2nd and 10. They look to throw. It's Lock. The Cards get to him here. He's brought down for a sack. He'll wind up losing a full 9 yards here on the sack. Now it's 3rd down.
And that sack, Charles, just looked like a case where a speedy defensive end is a little bit quicker than the offensive tackle.
Yeah, it makes it difficult for a tackle to determine what exactly to do. Do you do the kick slide and try and get back in the pocket and meet him there? Do you meet him on the line of scrimmage where they call a quick set? In any event, right now, he's having his troubles.
Now on 3rd and long, they'll look to throw. Open man, that's Noah Fant, the tight end. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. The defense shaking their heads, not aggressive enough, and they allow him to convert a 3rd and 18.
There's no doubt in my mind that not many guys in this league have had the impact that he's had here in the first half of the season. He's been a big play guy from the word go and continues to be one with another one right there.
And a nice little start as he's able to get this up to the 28. Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards, and it's 2nd and 2.
The success there, Charles, coming on the outside of the field, the ground game. Curious to see if that continues as we progress.
Yeah, we often talk about a variety in play calling and usually between run and pass. But in this case, with strictly the run game, you can be creative there as well. Run it inside, run it outside, keep the defense off balance.
On 2nd and a couple. Lock. This one into the hands of Metcalf. And he's going to be marked down just outside the 10.
And let's face it, that what we just saw there, not a surprise, is it? I mean, this is what he does well. And if you don't tackle him as soon as he catches the ball, this is the end result. Big yardage afterwards.
Got the speed, the agility, so good with run after catch. And we're only in the first quarter, so they better get a wrangle and a hold on that quickly.
Yeah, you're exactly right. And what's really difficult to try and defend him is if you want to press him so that you get him on the ground quickly after the catch, a lot of times he'll just run past you at the initial point of contact, and he'll go deep.
Walker now on first and 10. And here he'll get it down to the 7. It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up second down.
Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense that next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
Second and 6 with a ball on the 7. Block off of action. To the goal line, but it's incomplete.
It's been a good opening drive offensively thus far, but you know they don't want to waste it and settle for a field goal attempt after that incompletion. So this is a big play coming up here on third down.
Play number 9 now on this pretty long opening drive, but this is third down. On third down, here's Walker. And the second wave of tacklers is going to get him as they stop him behind the line. Not at all what they envisioned on third down, 3 yards in the wrong direction.
How about the job there on the outside? Shed the wide receiver and was able to make the tackle on the perimeter.
And his kick is right there. It's good. So he's been automatic to this point of the season, and he connects on the field goal there.
And what a luxury it is to have a kicker you can depend upon, partner, because he hasn't missed all year long. Converts on that one as well. And kudos to you. You didn't jinx him.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Murray and the Cardinals with a first and 10 at their 25-yard line. Now the Georgia Southern man, it's Matt Breida. And nothing much materializing there on the first down run. He'll get a couple and that's it.
Well, this defense for the Seahawks, they were terrific last week in the win over the Rams.
Yeah, what stood out to me on tape, the way they were flying to the football. So that tells me that they've got all their assignments down and they're playing with extreme confidence.
They'll break the huddle, come up on second and 8 at the 27-yard line. They stay on the ground. Again, it's Breida. And he'll take this up near the 35, maybe the 34.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon. And the Seahawks add a couple of extra DBs going with the dime look here.
Indeed, 6 on the field. Hey. Hey. Here's Murray. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
That was their first third down try of the game, and clearly something was off in the execution of that play. Good news, they've got a whole game left to clean that up and start clicking on those key third down throws.
On fourth down, here's Sam Martin on to kick it away. Kicks away as he angles this one for the sideline. And no return here. Where will they spot it? They say just outside the 20-yard line.
Seahawks offense. Yeah, they are trying to create some separation within the division. And look, CD, I know that this is still the first half of the season, but this is a big matchup no matter where it falls, because these are the top two teams right now in that division.
And if you can build a bit of a cushion as you head towards the second part of the season, that allows you to survive the expected injuries, potential upset losses, all of those things, and still be in good shape.
Play action, lock. Going for Metcalf on the deep ball. That's caught inside the 20. And all the way in, touchdown Seattle. For Drew Lock coming out of Missouri, the one thing that scouts, they love, was his arm strength. And we see why there.
And I'm telling you, nothing will light up a crowd more than a play like that. Here in the stadium, all eyes were on the receiver streaking downfield, and you know everyone was thinking, throw it, he's open. What a connection there for the touchdown.
And that throw, amazingly, well over 70 yards in the air, according to Next Gen Stats. Wow. So an early 10-0 lead for them now as they kick it away. To bring this one out, he'll just go down to a knee and they'll take over at the 25. Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense coming off every player's friend, the open week from last weekend.
Oh, there's no doubt about that. Even if you're coming off of a loss as they did, the open week is exactly what you need after you kind of get over it a little bit, right? Rest up the mind, rest up the body, get yourself ready to go. And they have to be eager to play again, especially since they lost the last time out. Now that's a mountain of a man that just made that stop, isn't it? But he's more than that. This guy's nimble and quick, more than a space eater. He just made a great play there.
On second and nine, Murray. Pressure comes, he's taken down by the Seahawk defense. Boye Mafe, the outside linebacker, coming up to drop him for a loss of a full 10 yards.
And this is what you've got to do against a quarterback like him. You've got to keep him in the pocket and not let him get to the perimeter, because once he gets outside, that's where he can really hurt you.
Sack puts Murray and the Cards in a tough spot. Third and long. And they'll send the slot in motion left. Snap comes to Murray at one. Finding his target is Trey McBride. It'll be a pickup of 16, but they'll remain short of the marker, and it's fourth down.
I think that we all figured when he caught it that short of the marker that the defense almost relaxed and said, we got this covered, and then all of a sudden, space to run after the catch, and now they're screaming, somebody get him down. Fortunately, they got to him and forced the fourth down.
10-0 the score after one on EA Sports. Now the punter, Sam Martin, called on to kick it away here. Four on his first punt, and this is a good kick as well. This is taken at the 15. It'll be a 51-yard punt that time. Seahawk football as they take over deep in their own territory. The Seattle offense ready to get this drive underway.
Well, partner, you know, coaches always say that every play is designed to score a touchdown. Sometimes that's not really true, but last drive, that was the case. One play to get into the end zone, and now they'll try to duplicate that success here.
And it's rare for those moments to happen. Incredible when they do. And you saw the celebration. Pure, unbridled joy after that one.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Here's Locke to throw. Going for Metcalf on the deep ball. And that's caught inside the 35. And all the way in, touchdown Seattle. What a first half he is compiling here. He's already over 100 yards receiving and now two touchdowns, CD.
Brandon, you know I don't like to play the game where you start projecting when you're at a certain point. But let's face it, he's off to a tremendous start. So 200 yards, four touchdowns. I don't think anything's out of the question right now. He's blowing up coverages. You've got to double him every snap. Otherwise, he's going to defeat you on almost every play.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. Taken at the goal line. Now a crease here as he's past the 30. There he goes, right side. Past the 20. He will take this all the way. Touchdown, Arizona. I know a lot of special teams coaches, they just want to keep it away from him because that's what he can do.
And others have egos that their players can't keep up with. And they say, challenge him, kick it to him. The way he runs, as fast as he is, I wouldn't challenge him at all. I'd do everything possible to keep it away.
He is just a blur when he gets a full head of steam, and he got a full head of steam there. Extra point splits the uprights, and that'll cut the lead to 17-7. So let's try this again after the kick return TD. Here's yet another kickoff. Here's Moore. He will return it. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one. Into the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. They have to be pleased with the way that they've moved the football thus far.
And why wouldn't they be? Two touchdowns on a field goal in their first three possessions. They're playing so well right now, the field goal probably feels like a disappointment.
Throwing on first down is Locke. That is taken in by the tight end Fant. And they'll get it all the way up about 5 yards shy of midfield. That'll be marked as a 27-yard pickup.
And that's patience to be admired right there, because he looks left, looks right, and waits for the right guy to come open, spots him in the middle of the field, and delivers.
The big play to start him out has him at the 45 already. Throwing now is Locke. Going right back to Fant. And he is brought down, but not before reaching the 30.
happened there because it allowed him to lock in on his receiver, although I think he was looking for his tight end on the corner route all the way. Nice connection there for a really nice gain.
So in the Cardinal territory now, it's first and 10 at the 30-yard line. Now a play fake, and here's Locke. This is caught by Evans. And all the way in, touchdown Seattle. Mike Evans with touchdown number 8 on the year. And his guy's now an extra point away from taking a 3-score lead. And there they got him the ball. Just get it to him, let him do the rest.
You know, he probably said that to his quarterback as he broke the huddle. I like the play call. Just get it to me. I'll take care of the rest of it.
Helping out his rack, right? RAC.
Run after catch. And he loves that. And he's going to carry that in at contract time.
The kick unit for the Seahawks out there on the field. And we are ready to rock. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And he'll be out of bounds across the 25. Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. It's been an awfully slow start for them. This is their third possession. They don't have a first down yet.
So that means they have to change up what they're doing, and for some teams, it's a change in tempo, usually moving it to more up-tempo type of an offense, just to try and change their fortunes right now. What they've been doing so far isn't working. Maybe they'll do that.
They take a shot downfield there, but it winds up falling incomplete.
The scoreboard tells the story for them, a little bit bleak, and while it's not quite desperation time yet, it's definitely getting close, but the defense reads the scoreboard as well. They're going to back up and make them really earn it.
Now Murray off play action. And he'll be hit as he releases it. And that'll fall incomplete.
Well, so far in this drive, they've done some good work. They force incompletions on first and second down, bring up third and 10. That brings up the big question. Do they bring pressure, or do they play coverage on this down?
Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. Now Murray. He's going deep for Brown. And unable to connect. Incomplete. Well, give him credit. They took their shot, but it's going to bring up fourth down.
Good clean play. No flags coming out of the pocket of the officials. Turns into an incompletion, and that should get him off the field with a three and out.
Here's Sam Martin now as he's on to punt for Arizona. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. Here's the Seattle offense ready to get this drive underway. Well, everything right now that they touch on this side of the football, it seems to turn to gold. They've scored on 3 straight possessions. That lead continues to grow. And, I mean, if they can get points here, Charles, might almost be an insurmountable comeback for the other side.
I think you make a great case for that, so I'm going to flip it over to the other side. Could they make the big comeback? Certainly. Am I expecting it? Not at all. I think if we don't see a drastic change in how they're playing, this blowout's going to get bigger and bigger before the final gun.
incomplete pass here now is second and 10. Lock gonna throw. Going for Metcalf on the deep ball. All right, rifles one, that's gonna be intercepted. Jalen Thompson picks it, and the Cardinals are gonna take possession of the football. That passing game has been spectacular this afternoon. Finally, a win for the defense.
You think maybe there was an adjustment there. Finally gained a measure of, I don't even know if you call it revenge, but got a play done against him, and that's been difficult for them all game long.
On first down, here's Breida. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8 yard gain, second and two.
First play of the drive, let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
Yards the gain on that last run. Here's second and a couple. Murray now to throw. And incomplete.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
The Cardinals on third down, 0 for 3 to this point. They could use a conversion. This time they face a third and two. They'll try to pick this up on the ground with Breida. And he gets this down to the 18. Good enough for a first down. 4 yards on the pickup. Good enough to extend the drive.
Yeah, they really needed to get something going, didn't they? They had punted on the last two possessions. The running game starting to come to the front for them, providing a nice pickup there to keep this drive going.
They run the option here at first and 10. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. No gain there as he kept it himself at second down.
Well, for that being an option play, there really weren't too many options available for him, were there?
No, there weren't, and at least he was able to get back to the line of scrimmage, so he didn't lose anything, but you're exactly right. Nowhere to go.
On play action, it's Murray. And this throw incomplete. And the defender all over him that time, and it's going to lead to third down.
They certainly did a nice job improvising there, extending the play, hoping someone would come open downfield, but they never did.
An incomplete pass on second down. That muddles things a little bit here. This is third and 10. To throw, it's Murray. Only able to get back a yard for his efforts, and that leads us to fourth down.
I'm not quite sure what he thought he saw there, but the reality was certainly a much different picture than what he anticipated. And give credit to the defense. They were down on the flash when he broke out of there, and it forced him out with almost nothing to show for his efforts.
His kick is good, and that will close the gap down to 14. So, Charles, they get to them with their first turnover of the game and then make it hurt a little bit extra with a field goal.
And anytime you give the ball up, what's the first thing a coach tells his defense? Don't let them score off of this. You've got to put out the fire. In fact, in 2021, that's what one NFL coach termed his defense, the fireman. Go out there, guys, and don't let them put some points on the board.
On the return, it's Eskridge, and he'll bring it out. And the decision to bring it out, not a good one, as he's tackled at the 15. Now we're going to get a timeout here as it looks like there's a Seahawk injured on the play.
While they come out and take a look at him, we will step aside for just a moment.
Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense.
As the offense comes out here, Charles, maybe perhaps a bit more of a focus on the run game for this drive after tossing an interception on the previous one.
I think that's a good way to look at it and a good way to think about it, but maybe they get to it in a little bit different way, because after you throw an interception, you want to make sure you keep your quarterback's confidence high. So maybe give him a couple easy throws that he can complete, and then get to the running game and try and get things settled down.
Yeah, and still in the first half here, a long way to go.
He's put up numbers in this one by pushing the envelope a bit whenever he could with deeper throws. But let's play a little philosophy here. Some plays it works, sometimes they're ready for you. And that time, they were on guard, incomplete.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. They fake the handoff. Now Locke. Flushed out right. And he's going to be taken down. Sacked back at the 2. 1:57 to go in this first half on EA Sports. A lot of ground to cover here for Locke and the Seahawks. Third and long after that sack. In his end zone, here's Locke. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
That might be the third down stop that they needed, because they've had a lot of trouble slowing down this offense in the first half. This might be their opportunity to get off the field.
Now here's Michael Dixon, and no room for error here as his first punt comes from deep in his own end zone. So a short drop, but he's able to get it out, and this is a good kick. Ross on the return. A very nice punt that time, but they get 11 back on the return. And the Cards will take over, first and 10. Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And after the field goal last time, we'll see what they can get here. At least they got points out of the last drive, Charles.
I never met an offensive coach that didn't want a drive to end with a kick. Most of them want to end with a PAT, right? In this case, a field goal, they'll take it. Way better than the alternative, which is a punt.
Yeah, but you met fan bases that won.
Murray has it knocked loose, fumble.
But this will fortunately wind up out of bounds. A nifty bit of scrambling there. 12 yards, first down.
Can almost see inside his face mask there the look of relief. He coughed it up, but it goes out of bounds. They keep it.
Someone carrying around the lucky horseshoe, aren't they? If I were him, I'd go out and play the lottery after that one. A very fortunate man.
And they're operating in plus territory here. They're thinking points. Definitely don't want to lose the football at this juncture.
First down, Murray. And that is incomplete. Wow, the coverage a little too good there, and it's second down.
He did a fine job there of not hitting him before the ball arrived, and I've got to tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well and think, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly and knocked it free.
To throw once more on second and 10, Murray. And this will be well too low for him to bring in. It's incomplete.
Feels like they're getting caught in between here, because they had incompletions on first and second down. Now you got to worry a little bit about the clock, because you prefer not to give them another shot here in the first half. But if you don't pick up the first down, guess what? You're likely going to have to.
From the gun on third down, Murray. He lets this one fly toward the back of the end zone. And that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down.
This defense has certainly played well so far in this game, and the coverage has been tight on just about every throw. Forced a few here so far in this game, and now it brings up fourth down.
Here's Sam Martin now. He's been one of their few bright spots so far. Now the Cards going to call another timeout, their second, as they stop it prior to what will be an important fourth down. So look at this. Here's the field goal unit coming out. And he is going to need to bomb this one. They spot it on the midfield stripe. So it is a 60-yard attempt here. And that will wind up just short. He had it online. It ran out of gas at the end. And this will remain a 2-touchdown game.
I don't care who you are. 60 yards is a very ambitious attempt. Hard to make even in practice in the best of conditions. And now, worst of all, you give the other guys the ball to start their drive at midfield.
Good starting field position here for the Seahawks as they come up first and 10 right at the 50-yard line. From midfield, here's Locke. Going for Metcalf on the deep ball. And this one is incomplete.
He certainly had a good game throwing the ball so far, but I think he was trying to take that from good to great with that throw, trying to get one downfield.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Now Locke. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
They have to like what they've done defensively here at the outset of this drive. They forced a couple of incomplete passes, bring up a third and 10. Don't be surprised to bring a little pressure on this snap.
So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a third and 10. From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. He's got his tight end fan, and he is going to have a Seahawks first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
And that's well executed there on third down, and I love the confidence that they had to let their tight end try and find some space in the middle of the field right in their quarterback's line of vision. And QBs love to make that easy throw, and they hooked up there for a first down.
Lock now on first down. Touchdown, Seahawks! Noah Fant, 34 yards. And the Seahawks will extend their lead in the final minute of the half.
That score that they just gave up there, that's a tough one for their defense to swallow because they've had a tough time through the first two quarters. They really were determined to get a stop there. Unable to do so, that makes their comeback hopes that much more difficult.
Point after, right down the middle. And the lead now to 3 touchdowns at 21. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. Taking it about the one. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line. Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And the ball backed way up, so thinking with this amount of time on the clock, probably just sit on it, and we'll see these two teams go to the lockers.
Yeah, I don't think you want to overthink it in this situation. Either side of the ball, just go ahead and finish up the half and get on out and talk about it.
So we are at halftime here in downtown Seattle with the Seahawks out in front. As we send you cross-country to Orlando, Jonathan Coachman is there and has our EA Sports halftime report. Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number three. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. It'll be the Cardinals who get the ball first. They trail here as we resume action in the third quarter. This taken in at the goal line. And he will make it to the 20-yard line and no further. Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And you have to think, Charles, down three scores already. They need to play an almost perfect second half to have a solid chance.
And that absolutely starts with finding some way to put together a touchdown drive here. They need to be smart, fast, efficient, get the ball to the end zone, and do it again multiple times in order to have a chance to win this game. Well, this certainly feels like complimentary football to me, partner, because the momentum from the team's touchdown drive looks like it's made its way over to the defense. They're working together in tandem now. Offense gets in the end zone. Defense with a big sack on the first play of the following drive.
Throwing on second and long. Murray. He'll get this complete to Rondale Moore. And he's able to get this one all the way past the 30. 23 yards the pickup there.
Well, we talk all the time about playing situational football, and right now I think the scoreboard is dictating what they need to do. Where they are in this game, they've got to push the ball downfield, take their shots, try and get big chunks of yardage in a short amount of time. That was a nice play there.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Play action. Now it's Murray. A hit as he throws there, incomplete.
Just what they need, a lecture from me, but subpar offense is what helped get them into this spot. And now they're continuing the trend with incompletions. That won't get them out of it if they don't change something soon.
Line of scrimmage, the 31, as they line up, second and 10. The man in motion is Brown. On second and 10, Murray. He's going deep for Brown. And the defense has it covered. It's intercepted. Tariq Woolen puts it.
Well, they're certainly in a bad way right now. Not so bad that you can call this one over already, but bad enough that you know you can't toss an interception to open the second half. This just ratchets up the pressure on defense right now.
Here's the Seattle offense ready to get this drive underway. But they had the big halftime lead. Their defense just helped them out further by forcing the turnover, so things are starting to look pretty rosy.
They certainly are, but they've got to be careful about getting complacent, though. They they still need to go out and run their offense efficiently.
Jerry Tillery running in there and setting him down. Don't need it all back at once, but you figure they're going to need something here. 17 yards to go on second down. Another try after the first down sack. Locke going for Metcalf on the deep ball. And that's caught inside the 35. And he'll be brought down at the 27. And that looked almost to be a case of, you know, a quarterback saying, hey, I'm going to throw this as far as I can and hope you run under it. Mission accomplished.
And he made that look effortless, didn't he? I mean, he's had a great game throwing the football. This is going to add to his yardage total in a big way. It's one thing to be accurate on your short and intermediate throws, but when you're hitting the bombs like those, look out.
And that throw, wow, 72 yards in the air, according to Next Gen Stats.
Not too many missteps in the red zone thus far. He was going for his fifth touchdown pass. His man couldn't shake free there, but boy, you know he's going to take another shot before this one's over.
Yeah, exactly, because you know three is good, four is excellent. You get five, that's a whale of a game. Try again on second down. Touchdown! Noah Fant, his second touchdown of the afternoon, as his guys have opened up a very comfortable lead. So another touchdown there, and even though we're still just here in the third quarter, kind of hard now to see them giving up this lead.
And this is just an offense that's imposing its will right now. You name it, they're able to do it. If you're the play caller, whatever you want to select is there. You want to run it, you want to throw it, pick a play, any play. They're rocking and rolling right now.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. Fields it right around the goal line. And no alley to be found. The coverage was solid, and he's dropped at the 18. To go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. Well, we haven't exactly been treated to a nail biter in this one, CD, and if they cannot score here, this one's pretty much all but over.
Are you saying that you feel like people are starting to think about getting out of here, maybe beating the traffic in order to get home or to their final destination?
Yeah, I don't think there's a whole lot of reason to hang around, especially if they can't score here.
Yeah, you're right about that, because it has been pretty clear who the better team has been in this one. And in a league that we talk about every game being a one-score game as we go into it, watching this blowout, let's just say it's been unusual.
He's going to let this one go deep. And this time will be intercepted. Picked off by Josh Jones. Well, to be blunt, not a whole lot has gone right for this defense in this ball game, but that's something right there, still in the third quarter. It would take something around miracle territory for a comeback, but maybe that's a start, Charles.
It certainly is, and they're definitely showing that there's some fight still left in them. Hasn't been a banner day, but they're trying their best to put that disappointment behind them and find ways to make plays.
Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. Well, they got to be thrilled with how they've operated so far in this one. They've got the nice lead, and now a chance to score here on three straight possessions.
Yeah, and the way that they are rolling, I just don't know how they get slowed down, because they certainly are operating at peak efficiency right now. They might want to think about giving some of their backups a little bit of work, though. Let some other guys get on the field and do their thing and save some of this for the next time out. Oftentimes when you're losing a game and the team's still throwing with this kind of a lead, you start playing a little more physically. and they took that opportunity right there to be extremely physical and force that incompletion.
We sit in quarter number three out in Seattle, a second and 10 now. Play action. Now it's Locke. Going for Metcalf on the deep ball. This is caught at the 20. And they're going to get this down to about the 17-yard line here. The defense, they weren't fooled on that post route. They just couldn't make the play.
And the offense definitely tried to fool them because you saw the other route combinations, didn't you? Anything that they were running, trying to draw attention away from the deep part of the field, but still had it covered, yet they were able to come up with a nice play.
A real field flipper there as all of a sudden they've got a first down in the red zone. Block off of play action. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Carl Lawson with a little how do you do as he gets in there for the sack.
This is a little hard for me to compute because I'm watching sack after sack happen, but somehow they're still behind in the game. I would expect all of this defensive pressure to translate to them taking a lead, and thus far, it hasn't happened. Time's winding down. They don't want to waste this type of performance from these ace pass rushers.
His throw caught right around the six. Give him 18 yards on that one. And that'll bring up what looks to be a third and inches. Can't be more than a half a foot.
That's a good bounce back play right there after taking a sack on first down. Didn't quite get it to the marker, but now they're in a much better spot for a third and short yardage call. If you're the offensive coordinator, you like looking at that section a heck of a lot better than trying to figure out third and long.
On play action, Locke. On the move to his left. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
Well, the connection they've had has been excellent today, but not on that snap. I think he was asking just a little too much as he extended that play, hoping for one more completion with him.
Now a timeout called for by the offense. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. For it. It's Walker, and he'll be touched down here, but not before he does pick up the first. Just a gain of three, but they'll certainly take it as they convert on fourth down. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
In any event, it happened pretty quickly. I'm not sure he made the right decision on that one. I think if he had it to do over again, he would have found a different target downfield. But he made his decision, and that one's incomplete.
A line of scrimmage once again, the five, as they get ready for second and goal. Block now to throw. A quick throw there, going to be batted away and incomplete.
Coaches talk about it all the time. Players talk about it as well. Excellent job staying disciplined in coverage and making that stop. Inside the red zone, every stop like that could be preventing a possible touchdown.
Third and goal as they look to pour some more salt in the wound. Locke going to keep this. They'll try and run Walker. And he will take this one in for a Seattle touchdown. Ken Walker, his second rushing touchdown on the year. And the Seahawks have taken a 5-touchdown lead. Extra point right down the middle, and the lead grows even larger here in the third quarter. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. is fielded right at the goal line. And he had no room to run as he's tackled down inside the 20. Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense.
Well, we're still in the third quarter, so there's some time to kind of clean this up and make it look more respectable. Now, a win, that's probably gone out the window, Charles, but
he's got a man complete. And they're going to get this down to about the 37. Hey, you need a big play? Go to your big play guy.
Listen, that's football 101. When you have to have it, you expect that guy to step up. A lot of people call these receivers divas. Sometimes just leadership when they get in the huddle and say, get me the ball, I'm about to make a big play.
Big ass open, big ass open. Come back.
Throwing on first down is Murray. And he's got the hook up to Moore.
And he'll be taken down here just shy of the 30.
And as they come to the line, they will not be able to get off another play as time has run out on this third quarter. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Second down at 4. Murray now. And his throw is going to be incomplete.
They lead big, and a major part of that has been how they've taken their play to a whole new level this second half. No points allowed since the break, and you can add another incompletion to the total number that they've forced in this runaway contest.
Throwing again, Murray. And that is incomplete.
And that's another play that's painted the picture of this game overall. It's been a blowout. It's been continually fueled by big turnovers and stops for one side and an inability to advance the ball from the other.
And now out is the Cardinal field goal team here. And he'll be kicking into the wind in the fourth quarter now. And this one looks good. It is good. Right down the pipe. So that, Charles, a season long right there.
And you know who's really excited about that? The special teams coordinator, because he's the one who has to tell the head coach in pregame, this is where we trust him from. This distance, he can hit it, and he repaid that trust by knocking that one right through.
Now it's Martin to do the honors after the made field goal. Taking it about the 1. And not a great return here. He'll make it back only to the 10-yard line. Here's the Seattle offense ready to get this drive underway.
Well, they don't really need the points here, Charles, given what we're looking at on the scoreboard, but they've scored on 3 consecutive possessions, 3 consecutive drives, and I'm sure that they would like to keep that streak going here and continuing to...
And now this is intercepted. My goodness. Picked off by Byron Murphy. And the Cards are going to take possession of the football. Charles, whatever's going on between his ears right now, it's just not completely calculated correctly. 7 picks between last week and this week after
say the most important part of a player is those 6 inches between the ears. But right now, it's all those interceptions that are going on. So whoever his trusted confidant is on the sidelines, I don't know if it's the offense coordinator, the quarterback's coach, maybe the backup quarterback, that's who he needs to get with now and get himself calm.
And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes.
But one thing I do know, these guys on defense, they don't want this game to end. They're winning by multiple touchdowns. They've shut down the opposing quarterback in a big way, and they're still picking up sacks as we approach the end of this one.
Well, they're in some hot water now. After that sack, it's second and 21. In motion right is Brown. After the sack on first down, Murray, he's going deep for Brown. And that will be incomplete. Trying to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be third down.
We've seen that the deep ball's been a part of their game plan all afternoon, but they've had trouble hooking up on it, unable to successfully find the end zone over the top.
The Cardinals on third down. It's been a problem. Just 1 for 7 thus far. This will be third and forever. Murray going to throw. He'll let this go for the end zone. And it's intercepted at the goal line. And the Seahawks are going to take possession here. It's a touchback. And they'll take over at the 20-yard line. Well, they've got the huge lead. Now they have another interception on the defensive side. Seems like everything they touch in this one, Charles, turns to gold.
And they have to be awfully happy right there to get what appears to be one more for the road and help seal away one of their best efforts of the season.
Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And after the interception, they are sitting in an even better spot with the ball and a comfortable fourth quarter lead. Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. They'll roll him out right. And I think that one might have been intercepted, but he will be ruled out of bounds. So this will go only as incomplete.
I think it's fairly safe to call this game over, but they're still trying to bomb it downfield and add to their lead. Almost makes you start to feel for the defense and root for them a little bit, too.
They'll try again from the 20 on second and 10. Throwing now is Locke. Going for Metcalf on the deep ball. And it's knocked away and incomplete.
I like the fact that he took the shot deep downfield. Even if you don't get the catch, maybe you get a defensive penalty and pick up the yardage that way.
Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. To throw it is Locke. Open man is Metcalf. He's got it. And he'll have this past the 30 prior to going out of bounds. Locke fighting Metcalf for the Seattle first. Well, there's absolutely been no stopping this offense today. They already have the big lead, obviously. Here in the fourth quarter, they could coast to the end, but right now they're not passing up any chances to put up some garbage time yardage.
And, partner, why would they? Because who knows the next time you'll be playing as well as you have today when you're...
And this is caught inside the five. fake, and here's Locke. And that'll be off the mark, too far out in front, and it's incomplete. The CD, they're up big, but they're still passing it. I mean, this is an offense that's had a lot of success in this game, and it seems like they're just having fun out there.
And it does feel like there's been a shift out there, doesn't it, partner? Listen, if you're up, you can continue to do what you want to do. It's up to the other team to make you change how you do things. They'll continue to throw it around until stopped.
Line of scrimmage, again the 4-yard line, second and goal. Here's Locke. Touchdown, Seahawks. DK Metcalf with his third touchdown so far, number 13 now on the year. And the Seahawks add on to their lead, and they are also closing in on a fifth straight victory. Extra point splits the uprights, and this one was over a while ago as they just add on to that big lead. The kick unit for the Seahawks out there on the field, and we are ready to rock. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. They were coming off the extra week of rest, but this team started sluggish, and it really didn't get any better from there. And trailing big here in this fourth quarter. And not much to speak of. Call it a 1-yard gain up to the 26.
He continues to struggle to find a crease to break off a big one and might need to just put that aside and just try and ram his way forward and get what he can.
Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run. They run again with Breida. And not a whole lot there, maybe a yard to the 27.
Ladies and gentlemen, that is a force of nature at the defensive tackle position. Yes, he's as big as they come, but still plenty agile. He's able to make a nice play there to swallow up the ball carrier.
Be a nickel look here for the Seahawks on third down. Here's Murray. And that is incomplete.
At this point in the game, they've got to continue to try anything they can. They're still working at it, even though this one feels like a lost cause.
Here's Sam Martin now. He's been terrific so far. He gets this away. It's a good one. Drawing toward the sidelines. There, this punt will go out of bounds. I think it'll be inside the 25, and it will. Right at the 24-yard line is where they'll spot it. Here's the Seattle offense ready to get this drive underway. And it's looking all the more likely that a fifth straight win is going to be in the cards. They'll try to run some time here with a first and 10. They take a shot downfield there, but it winds up falling incomplete.
Partner, in the sportsmanship handbook, there's something to be said for calling the dogs off in a blowout. But these defenders, they also know this is the NFL, and it's their job to stop them, whether they're in the game or they're down by a handful of touchdowns.
From the 24, they'll go again on second and 10. gonna throw. Airing this one out for Evans. And that gonna be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down.
Well, up big here in the fourth quarter, up really big. That passing incompletion, I don't think they needed the completion, but Charles, this is an offense right now that they're just having fun. They're clicking on all cylinders.
Yeah, you're right. They didn't need a completion. They certainly don't need any more points, but they're not going to turn them down. They're going to continue to run what they have in their playbook, and they still want to run it efficiently.
Here's Locke to throw. And it's going to be incomplete. He was able to catch it there on the right sideline, but out of bounds, says the line judge. And it's going to bring up fourth down.
Well, they're up comfortably here, Charles, but that lead certainly not dissuading them from pressing the envelope late. I mean, if anything, with these passes, it's like they're getting more aggressive to try to drive the ball downfield.
And that will certainly lend itself to some post-game questions for that coach, and maybe you and I should attend that press conference and see what he has to say, because someone's going to ask him why he continued to push it. My guess, he didn't like how some of the snaps were run earlier, and he wanted to use that as a chance to clean things up, but he certainly will have some explaining to do.
Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense.
Where we stand right now in the fourth quarter, this one pretty much out of reach. And Charles, I know they're going to be disappointed about several things with this ball game, but the self-inflicted wounds, they've had several turnovers.
He's got a man complete, and he's across for the touchdown. Too little, too late, but he does get in for six.
No wonder you're grinning. You just beat me in our fantasy league.
Indeed I did, my good man. I know this defense knew it coming into the game, Charles, and they know it even more now. DeAndre Hopkins is a tough cover.
And anytime you see him out there and there's less than double or triple teaming him, take a shot with him. Just what you're talking about. If he's such a tough cover, one guy's not going to get it done. Throw the ball out there. Let him go get it.
Here's Martin now following the score as he'll send this one away.
Taken at the goal line.
And they're going to start in a hole as he's brought down at the 11. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense.
Well, we've reached the stage where it's a mere formality at this point. They've got the comfortable lead. We know what the outcome is going to be. I guess the only question is, do they want to put more points on the board before the final gun?
Well, I certainly hope not, and I'm being selfish here because you and I have flights to catch. Let's go ahead and finish this one off, guys. You've taken care of business. Let's close it out. And you and I, let's get to the airport.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. They look to throw. It's Locke. Going for Metcalf on the deep ball. It got his man complete. And they are going to score again. Yet another touchdown as they just add to their totals.
But Charles, in this win, they've really just had one speed, and that's been all out. They're still driving the ball downfield despite the circumstances and the big lead, and they just continue to find ways to get into the end zone with ease.
They're certainly in that zone where almost everything they try is successful and often leads to points. Teams don't get those types of games very often, so when they do, many of them just want to take advantage of it to the last second.
The kickoff unit is out on send this one away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. We said it at halftime that they would need a nearly perfect second half to erase that deficit that they were facing, CD, but unfortunately, the second half has pretty much been a carbon copy of the first.
Yeah, that early lead was almost insurmountable the way their opponent was playing, and partner, they do have some good news, though. This one is getting close to being over, and they can try and hit the reset button starting tomorrow.
They'll operate from the 32-yard line here, second and three. Here's Murray. Looking left sideline, but it's incomplete.
That incompletion is not a surprise with the way that this one has gone, and the frustration, the body language is evident everywhere. This team, they've really been put through the ringer in this one.
So the incomplete pass on the last play, and that leads us to a third and three. To throw is Murray. That's complete to John Ross. And he'll go out of bounds, it looks like, right at the 40. 7 yards there, good enough to move the sticks.
Well, you can absolutely feel the thought process there. They just gave up the touchdown. So in the huddle, they're telling each other, you don't want to give it back now on a three and out. Nice job of making sure that they wouldn't, and they pick up the first down.
The tight end in motion right. Murray now on first down. Catch is made by Marquise Brown. And they're going to get this to about the 44-yard line. First down, Murray. This will be caught once again by Brown. And he's going to be taken down right at the 40-yard line. From the 40 now on second down, Murray. He's going to look deep down the field. And this is caught. Well, they get one back, picking up the late touchdown here, but still down big.
And yeah, that touchdown counts for their team, but I think it counts more for the fantasy guys, doesn't it?
Yeah, it's just something maybe positive to look at on film, but this one's over, let's be honest.
Yeah, I agree with you totally on that one.
Now for the point after. Make the score a little bit more respectable here in our final quarter of play. So after the touchdown, Martin now on to kick this one away. And the fair catch is taken at about the 13-yard line here. the Seattle offense ready to get this drive underway. Well, they don't need to score here, that's for sure. They could just kneel it. They've got the huge lead late fourth quarter, but we'll see how they're feeling, Charles.
Yeah, we all know people out there who like to use every second of the clock, no matter what the score.
And that's caught inside the 30. And he'll be marked down at about the 26-yard line. A lot going to throw it here. Looking for the end zone. Toward the back corner of the end zone, but he could not get the feet down. This will wind up incomplete. And Charles, a lot of happy faces heading into the tunnel as this one ends. And understandably so, not only did they get the win, but boy, their offense was on fire in this ball game.
And partner, I have no idea what the top speed is on one of those high-end sports cars, what's the top gear you can get into. This offense, they certainly were there in this one, huh? Everything clicking for them in this contest, the kind of performance that they're going to cherish.
So for the Seahawks, the win moves them up to 5-2 now on the year. And they will hit the road next week for a date with the San Francisco 49ers. Meanwhile, for the Cardinals, the loss here will move them back to 500 at 3-3. And they'll be at home next week for a date with the Houston Texans.